This part is kind of a little bit more practical to show what we actually realized within last almost 10 years within code bases, how you can use code bases, what kind of platforms support it, and more importantly, what kind of environments for evaluations you can we already have. So first of all, I already kind of highlighted this part when I started, is starting point. So we have our Indian website, which is named data-net, that includes a lot of different information, that kind of overall information about the project. But the important part is code-based references, but also there is a large collection of publications, large collection of tutorials, and this additional information. And for the source code, all links are there. I'm just trying to highlight everything is what we develop in is open source, and most of them is on GitHub, and we have a few organizations on GitHub for just to separate logically what the code is about. So one is a generic name dash data, and there is a specific one is dash mobile dash IoT and dash NDN sim for our simulation platform that I will highlight a little bit later. And this slide highlights overall overall code base that exists in NDN universe that we can roughly split into infrastructure software, the libraries, and kind of applications and evaluation frameworks. So within the infrastructure code base, that I'll talk about a few components here. Some of them are highlighted, some of them not. But the core element is our software forwarder that I will talk a little bit more, which works on kind of traditional platforms and a little bit less traditional platforms. But we also focus on different architecture, different platforms, such as very constrained controllers. So I will mention that in a little bit more details as a NDN Riot. But we also have a micro forwarder for JavaScript, if you have some JavaScript playground, which can be considered. And there is a large number of tools. For the language support, that what you can use to write NDN applications, you can see there is a large set of languages supported. But besides just languages support, we have a set of the libraries. You know, like, some of them work with the sync concept that Lisha decided not to talk about in detail, as it's a bit more complex concept. But all of us will be happy to talk more afterwards. And the applications, there's a number of prototype applications for like chat application, video conferencing, and some other things. I'm not going to talk about them. But what I'm emphasizing a little bit more are evaluation frameworks that allow you to evaluate both applications and some internals of NDN, networking internals and some other things inside on different times, on different scales. Okay, so I already highlighted in the previous picture supported platforms, but it's a little bit more formalized version. So we support basic platforms, like traditional platforms like macOS, Linux, FreeBSD, but also already tried, there are some compiled versions for home routers. It's still Linux, but it's a constrained Linux environment which requires a few tweaks to work. We have a version for Android platform. Due to restrictions of the software, it's on iOS, we kind of compiled, but that will require quite a bit of hassle. So that's, the upper part is for pretty powerful devices, which you can also count Raspberry Pis. Kind of, it's still running the same software, it's still Linux, but kind of less constrained. But if you're playing with very, very constrained devices, like 32 kilobits, kilobytes of RAM or less, we also played with NDN. We actually built NDN support for two, kind of, there are two versions of support that we built. One is for Arduino platform. For that, we just built a small library to send the interest and receive data. But for the Riot OS platform, so Riot OS is a semi-operating system for kind of Arduino class platforms, Arduino or a little bit more powerful devices. And I already highlighted there is a JavaScript. So for the forwarder, for the software forwarder, this is our effectively main component that we use in our research for putting our research inventions inside this forwarder, plus using this component to drive application-based research. So kind of go in multiple directions. Again, documentation is on the website. There's a few elements there. For the user perspective, this is that would be your point of start. There is documentation how you install it on a traditional platform or less traditional platform. If you kind of more developer side and you want to help kind of to tweak or help us develop to develop NFD or to try to tweak something inside this architecture, we actually wrote NFD developer's guide. It's kind of very, very long document describing all internals of the forwarder. So if you're interested in that, it also linked on a website. So for the Android platform, as I already mentioned, we have NDN support on the Android platform, but it's actually not just this completely separate implementation, but rather the same NFD source code that we just brought to the Android platform and compiled as a NDK with a few tweaks, kind of set of applications that became a shared library. And like, in addition to just NFD, we also added a few management components that actually running in GUI of Android, and you can just by simple clicking you can start the engine or you can configure identities and so forth. Just to highlight, you don't need to root the phone, so if somebody in this room has an Android phone, you can go to Google Play and actually download an NDN stack and kind of enable your phone to support NDN. So that would be just NDN, so you still need to have additional applications to actually do something meaningful. And again, I forgot to link the additional app that is also available on Google Play. Going down to the traditional environments, so NDN Riot is implementation of NDN for this very, very constrained devices, like 32 kilobytes. Actually, this one is for 128 kilobytes of RAM, and I forgot how much CPU capacity Riot OS is targeting. But effectively, it's a library-based operating system, so it just provides you a set of components that you can bundle into your application effectively and flash to the small microcontroller, and it will be running. Nevertheless, what we achieved with the NDN Riot implementation is full support of NDN, so we absolutely can encode all these interest data packets and send them efficiently. Plus, we also played with the data-centric security. Alicia highlighted that in NDN, all packets are signed, plus potentially can be encrypted. So for this part, we played with the asymmetric cryptography on those small, small devices. It's not that fast, like I can admit that. It's taken in our initial experiments around half a second to create one signature. But for very big class of the applications where those sensors or like small controllers would be deployed, it's very interesting application where you actually have that small microcontroller producing some piece of data, and that data stays secured from the birth of that specific piece of data. It's named and secured at the same time. If you want to play more a little bit with this NDN Riot, again, everything is on GitHub, and I just added a few instructions of how you want to start playing with a few applications that we provided as part of this NDN IoT package. Again, this is going a little bit more details or showing slightly kind of various tools that are available in NDN framework. Given it's a new networking architecture, we need something to evaluate basic networking performance or kind of to see actually what is going on the wire. So for that purpose, we have NDN ping, kind of semi-equivalent of ping protocol or ping application for IP. Cat chunks, put chunks, it's some equivalent of iperf, if you know that. Pigpok is just the same thing, and we have a kind of extensive set of tools to evaluate what is happening on the wire. Like there is a dissector for the Wireshark, if you're using Wireshark, or this is simple tools like NDN dump is just trying to show some basic things about the packet flow. From the developer perspective, I already highlighted we have a kind of a large set of libraries. And on this slide, on these two slides actually, I want to highlight the links that where to go for the starting point, plus that we again welcome you to use the library, and we welcome you to contribute to the library in any form. Like your questions, like what the heck is how to install it, is extremely valuable lesson for us. So this is our basic library, our kind of base for most of the experiments that we're kind of driving in. But we also have a set of non-C++11 libraries, which kind of just basic C++, Java, JavaScript, C#, and this magical language called Squirrel. It's a legitimate language, so if you haven't heard, you can Google it and you'll find some links. And again, this is the link showing, pointing you to how to download, what is the APIs of these libraries. But my objective is to show we have many different languages, like whichever language you want, we most likely have. And the last part is about evaluations. Obviously, when you're working with the new NDN framework, networking architecture framework, you would like to evaluate various aspects of the architecture itself or applications in different environments. So for this purpose, we have multiple levels of kind of different fidelity, different complexity of starting the experiment, different scalability of that experiment. So the first level, which gives you the highest level of fidelity, is our NDN testbed. Right now, it's 37 nodes across 4 continents and many countries in different places, and the map is highlighting. And actually, this one would be a little bit outdated information, and kind of the testbed is constantly growing. And as is shown on the slide, it's open for you to join. So if you have a server that you can put in your company and kind of allow us to manage the server, or if you prefer, you can manage the server. It can be part of that magical testbed. And what you can do, you can connect to any point of this network as an application, and you can run this application as it is on this global NDN network. Of course, right now, all these nodes are connected over IP overlay, but eventually, we may have some kind of small islands of real NDN connectivity. I mean, given the scale, so you cannot have more than the nodes available in this network. You may not have more than 37 nodes running in your experiment. Plus, you have a potentially limited control over what kind of software. You can talk to our testbed operator to kind of negotiate when to run the experiment or what additional software is required, but it's a little bit problematic. If you want more control, a little bit potentially more scale, there's an ONL lab. So this one is real virtualization platform. So it's in the Washington University of St. Louis. There's like a few racks of servers that you can get easy, simple access, and you just run the experiment. Effectively, you got a slice of that rack, you got a set of VMs with pre-installed versions of NFD, and you run your applications. A similar but slightly different type of virtualization, but which not requiring additional external resources, is a mini NDN, which is based on a popular MiniNet framework. So this one is a kind of similar virtualization, more or less emulation, but it's running on a single machine. So you got the Linux box, you can virtualize some subset of nodes, like some set of nodes. This one is usable for medium scale, small to medium scale simulations. It gives you reasonable fidelity given, but it has limitations given it's on the same node, it's running in real time, and all the nodes on the same device are competing with the resources. And so if you have more control, if you want to have more additional nodes, so the best bet would be to use a simulation framework, and we have NDN Sim, a pretty popular package right now. It's based on NS3 network simulator with its disadvantages and disadvantages. But effectively, it's just NDN, kind of you realize an NDN stack, and you can play with this NDN stack in a very, very controlled environment. What I want to highlight on this slide is, again, we did not completely reinvent the NDN implementation for the NDN sim. We still took the same NFD code base that we kind of wrote and just plug it in inside the simulator. We had to do a few tricks to kind of change the real-time assumption about NFD to simulation time assumption. We had to kind of be very careful in event scheduling, like what's happening inside real code versus what's happening in NS3. But it's working. So there's advantage now. You can play with the simulation, like you decided, oh, that's a great, now it's working. And you can easily deploy that in different types of simulation, either mininet or testbed or like actual deployment of NDN.